والسلام. And thereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test him further. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his offspring away one after the other. They were all gone. They all died in front of his eyes. All of them. And he had been given a lot. Subhanallah. One after the other. With everyone, he would say, we all belong to Allah. Whatever he has given to us was always his. If he took it away, it just returned to who it belonged to always. This is Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the owner of everything. What I have got, what you have got, where did it come from? It came from Allah. If he wants, he can take it now, or he can take it later. Or he may decide never to give it to someone. That is the owner, Allah. لا يسأل عما يفعل. He is never going to be asked what he does, because he is the creator and the decider. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala found, after testing Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, now with the second line of attack, if we can call it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala found him to be grateful. He still says, ya Allah, you have still given me, and I thank you, and I praise you, and I remain in your worship, and I continue with my work. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test him finally with something very, very difficult. Very difficult. And remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the anbiya, the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their tests are far more difficult than the tests of the ordinary people. And then from amongst the ordinary people, those who are doing the work of the anbiya, their tests will also be more difficult than the layman on the street. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make life easy for us. May he not test us with tests that will be too difficult for us to pass, but rather may he test us with that we will pass inshallah with flying colors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then we decided to take his health away. Now the health is connected to two angles. Firstly, the outward, and then the inside. So you have organs that can go bad. People might not notice quickly, but you have the skin also that goes bad. When a person has organ failure, a lot of the times people will still come and greet him and talk to him and so on. But the minute the person has an outward sickness and illness blistering from top to bottom, people begin to develop a distance, because they think we might be infected by this, it may be contagious and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with both those, until there was a time when nothing was operating besides his heart and his tongue. And he still used that tongue to remember Allah. And he still used that heart, he never allowed it to lead him to frustration against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a lesson for us, my beloved brothers and sisters. We get sick, we get a flu, we get a cough, we get an agitation for a while, and we start making dua, we start with our pills and with our medication, and after a while we say, what's wrong? Allah is not curing me. How we lose hope in a week, in 2 weeks? This sickness lasted for a long, long time. Some narrations say it lasted 7 whole years. And a certain narration says that the people around him began keeping a distance until they decided, we need to remove this man from here. And you find even his own friends, they stopped coming. And one narration says that his wife, after some time, asked him a question. How long is this going to last? That made him so upset, because to him, he was surrendering to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, he might have been trying in his own way, whatever he wanted to, within the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he never wanted to question the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was not in his nature. And he was very upset that his own wife is asking, how long will this last? Yes. So he asks his wife a question. How long did Allah bless me with goodness? She looked at him and she said, 80 years. For 80 years you had goodness. You had health, you had wealth, you had offspring, you had everything. Now, how many years is he testing me for? She looked at him and she says, the last 7 years. So how do you want me to lose hope in the mercy of Allah when I haven't even reached par with what goodness I had and the difficulty I'm facing? It's not even equal. This is 7 years and that is 80 years of goodness. How can we become upset with Allah when he gave us almost a whole lifespan full of goodness? A lesson for us. Sometimes we suffer a loss one after the other and we don't realize 30 years we were smiling, we were happy. Now Allah says another 10 years, we want you to go through some turbulence, we want to test you. Like I normally say, people say, why does Allah take things away? Well, Allah says in the Quran, he will test you in every way. He tests you with addition and subtraction. And I've said that here before. That when you get a mathematics test, there's not only the plus sign that they test you with. What is 1 plus 1? You know, 5 plus 3, 10 plus 15. That's not all. They also ask you what is 15 minus 10. Because they want to test you the negatives as well. To see, do you know how to subtract? The same applies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us with addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, whatever He wants, He tests. And He tests it all round. This is why Allah says, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah says, Alif Lam Mim. Do the people think it is enough for them to say we believe and then Allah will not test them? Allah says, we have indeed tested those before you. Meaning we will test every single one of you. Subhanallah. Do they think it is enough for them to say we believe and then they are not tested? Allah says, no. When you say we believe, Allah says, now we want to test you in order to know who is truthful in their belief and who is just claiming by lips that I'm. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He told His wife, you can't tell me this. If I get better, I'm going to lash you 100 lashes. Now He made that statement. The statement came out because it showed how powerfully He was connected to the surrendering of to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when someone uttered a statement from his closest relatives saying, how long is this going to last? It made him upset. So he uttered the statement, I will lash you 100 lashes. And it is reported that she also found it very difficult. She found it very difficult and so on. And as time passed, one narration says, she actually decided, I'm now going. I can't handle this anymore. But we stick to the narration which says, it got to a point, almost breaking point. Almost breaking point. And he calls out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Remember when our servant Ayyub called out to us, telling us that, oh our Rabb, oh my Rabb, Allahu Akbar, oh my Rabb, evil has touched me, evil has touched me, and yet you are the most forgiving, most merciful. Which means, cure me, Ya Allah. You are most merciful and evil has touched me. Your mercy will dictate to remove that evil. Allah says, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, fastajabna lah. We responded. We responded that call. How? Now in another place in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention how. Allah says, وَذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا أَيُّوبَ. Remember, make mention of our slave. Look at the word used, abdana, our slave, our worshipper, Ayyub. إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ, when he called out to his Rabb, أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ بِنُصْبٍ وَعَذَابٍ. He called out to say, look, Shaytan has definitely harmed me with this and that, with difficulty, with hardship, with sickness, in wealth as well as in health. Loss in wealth as well as health. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we told him when he was standing, his wife was not there at the time, she was concentrating on something else. And Allah says, Urkud birijilik, which means strike the ground with your foot. That's the least he could do. Strike the ground with your foot, see what happens. So he struck the ground with his foot. A spring gushed, water, cold water started gushing from his feet. Allah says, هَذَا مُغْتَسَلٌ بَارِدٌ وَشَرَابٌ. This is cold water for you to wash yourself with and to drink. So as he washed, his blisters started disappearing. As he drank, the internal organs came in order again. To the degree that in a short space of time, his skin was renewed totally. Renewed totally. A new man. Allahu Akbar. And his internals were made again as good as they were before and even better by drinking this water. My beloved brothers and sisters, we also have water similar to that. We have a gift of Zamzam. We have the well in Makkah al-Mukarramah. Remember, it serves the same purpose. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Zamzam is for whatever intention it is drunk with and for. So if you're drinking it with the intention, Ya Allah, cure me, Ya Allah, this, Ya Allah, it will inshallah serve that purpose. For as long as you have that yaqeen and conviction in your heart, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from that gift. We don't take Zamzam for granted. Wallahi, it is water that is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This particular water was different from Zamzam, but it served similar purpose, where he got cure, and amazingly, when his wife came back, she looked and she says, Where is Ayub? Who are you? But you look very similar to him. MashaAllah. He says, I am Ayub. Allah granted me cure. Now there was a time, according to one narration, there was a time when the people around him were saying, Allah doesn't love this man. If Allah loved him, this wouldn't have happened to him at that time. And he continued, he says, never. I know that when Allah tests a person, he tests him this way as well. And he continued and he persevered. So Allah says, we tested him one, we tested him two, we tested him three with the most difficult tests. And he passed one, he passed two, he passed three. Then Allah says, okay, here's your dua, here's your water as a gift just by striking your foot on the ground. SubhanAllah. Then Allah says,
وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ
After that, not only did we return his health to him, but his family, we gave back family members double than what he had before. In a short space of time, Allah says, we gave him double what he had before. And Allah says, we gave it to him as a blessing from us and as a reminder for those with sound intellect, those who want to take heed. Now, how do we take heed? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a lesson. When Allah has tested you, when you are patient, the reward of that sabr is so great that there is no ways I can describe it to you. Allah says,
إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ
Allah recompenses the one who engages in patience and sabr in a way that is unlimited. Unlimited. It is reported that when a person is sick and ill and they are patient about it and they continue, and if they die in that condition, or when a person who was sick happens to die on the day of Qiyamah, when they see the reward that they accumulated solely by sitting and being patient, they will say, why didn't you keep us sick all our lives? We could have accumulated much more. So don't lose hope when you have a slight sickness here or there, terminal or not. We ask Allah to grant shifa to all those who are sick. Yes, it is an act of worship to go and seek cure. But at the same time, it is also an act of worship whilst the cure is being sought that we bear patience. The same applies when you've lost your loved ones. Look at Ayub alayhi salam. He lost all his children, all of them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we gave him a gift. We gave him his children and we multiplied them by two. A gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine. Allahu Akbar. Look at this gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we have lost a loved one, remember one thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you so much goodness in return. So much that we cannot describe it. Allah says, بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ Without limits, unlimited reward you will receive. But don't question the decree of Allah. Ya Allah, you took my child away. Why? No, don't ask Allah why. Say, Ya Allah, say what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. He held his son Ibrahim whilst this ruh was being taken away. And a tear rolled down the eyes of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the sahaba radiallahu anhum are watching. And he looks and he says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا أَخَذَ وَلَهُ مَا أَعْطَى وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى He says, definitely, for Allah is what he has taken away, and it belonged to him in the first place anyway. And he says, everything has a fixed time. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked him, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see you are crying, we see a tear rolling. He says, I'm not questioning the will of Allah. We are happy at the decree of Allah. But these tears, إِنَّمَا هِيَ رَحْمَةٌ جَعَلَهَا اللَّهُ فِي عِبَادِهِ الرُّحَمَى This is a sign of mercy that Allah has placed in the hearts of those who have a little bit of mercy. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to distinguish between the tears of sorrow that we are going to miss someone and so on, and that tears of mercy, and on the other hand, tears of anger and being upset with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May we never be on that condition. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He now returned the health of Ayyub alayhi salam. And as he is bathing, this hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari, as he is bathing, without his clothes on, he's bathing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent locusts that fell from heaven, from Jannah. And they came, pure gold locusts falling. Pure gold. This is a sahih, correct narration. And he started gathering them. And he was thankful to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks him, Oh Ayyub, you know we will take care of you. Why are you gathering these locusts? He says, Ya Allah, this is mercy from you, I must gather it. Subhanallah. So Allah restored his wealth in a miraculous way, health in a miraculous way, wealth in a miraculous way, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him children again in a miraculous way. Subhanallah. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he had one issue, one more issue. He swore that he would lash his wife 100 lashes if he was cured. Now he's cured. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, وَخُذْ بِيَدِكَ ضِغْثًا فَاضْرِبْ بِهِ وَلَا تَحْنَثْ Allah says, don't break your promise. He will show you a way out. You can take a little bunch full of grass-like branch, very light, and use that to whip, Allah says. So imagine now you're taking a bundle of little grass and you're using that. It has no pain, but you are not breaking your promise. Look how Allah taught him a way out of this, because he was genuine. He did not make a qasam for some silly reason, but it was because of Allah and because of his love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah showed him a way out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us also ways out of our problems and messes. Subhanallah. Sometimes really we have caused our own mess, and sometimes we are stuck in it. Believe me, this is the month of Ramadan. If you are sincere and you want to come out of your mess, wallahi, you can walk straight out of it by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.